So if you look across the lake here behind me, you'll see a few huts out there, but not nearly the number that you would have seen even just a decade ago. It's unfortunate, but the walleye fishery being closed down, the moratorium on them, has definitely limited the number of people visiting here in Port Perry and fishing the lake. But I gotta tell you, there's still a great fishery out there for panfish, particularly crappie, where people come from miles around. It's a great accessible fishery to get out and try. So over the years, this particular spot that we're on used to be just a mecca for walleye. Fish in this particular area were drawn to really nice green coontail weeds throughout the summer and stayed here for the winter. But the bottom's changed completely, and you don't see those green growths of weeds, those big tufts that hold those forage fish. Remember, they're small fish, they get eaten by bigger ones, so they need a place to hide, and that just doesn't exist here anymore. So it's really exciting to see the work that Josh and the team are doing with the Lake Stewards and the university to really get an understanding with these core samples of what's going on, what's happening, and why the change. If there's a possibility of restoring that, there's also the possibility of restoring the fishery to the way that it used to be. You know, there's 3.5 million anglers in Canada which spend approximately $8.5 billion every year on fishing. So the economic impact of a healthy fishery in any location, any town, can't be understated. As unfortunate as the moratorium is for the walleye here on the lake, which is really a healthy move for everybody involved to restore the fishery to the way that it used to be. Remember that there's still an incredible fishery here. Panfish, and particularly crappie, draw anglers from all over North America to fish in waters like this.